Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen. Amen.
Was it the Pope, Margaret?
I'm feeling it's a scam.
Oh, good. Well, there you go. No need to respond. A happy feast day for the feast day of St. Chad and St. Sad.
Happy feast.
Thank you very much. We'll think about them after our readings. The first reading, we continue Romans 8, utterly astounding. The whole of creation waits with eager longing for the Lord to reveal the sons and daughters. It's us, this incredible binding of us with creation, but waiting for us to be revealed as the sons and daughters of the Lord. That we hear and are transformed by the word, let us turn and ask the grace of the Spirit. You, O Lord, are the Son of God, begotten before the ages. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are our great High Priest forever and ever. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Your gift of faith is the source of our salvation. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
When I was in the town earlier this morning, I met one of the parishioners who hasn't been able to come back yet. So let's be aware of those that we have not seen for so long, their needs and their desires to be spiritually filled with the Word and with the Eucharist. Let us pray. O God, who called your servants, the bishops, Saints Chad and Sad, from among the English who first turned to Christ your Son, and made them ministers of grace to their own people, grant, we pray, at their intercession, that we may imitate them in a peaceful and humble spirit and a prayerful life, and so commend to others the faith which we ourselves profess. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. I think that what we suffer in this life can never be compared to the glory, as yet unrevealed, which is waiting for us. The whole creation is eagerly waiting for God to reveal his sons. It was not for any fault on the part of creation that it was made unable to attain its purpose. It was made so by God. But creation retains the hope of being freed, like us, from its slavery to decadence, to enjoy the same freedom and the glory as the children of God. From the beginning till now, the entire creation, as we know, has been groaning in one great act of giving birth. And not only creation, but all of us who possess the first fruits of the Spirit, we too groan inwardly as we wait for our bodies to be set free. For we must be content to hope that we shall be saved. Our salvation is not in sight. We should not have to be hoping for it, as it were, but as I say, we must hope to be saved, since we are not yet saved. It is something we must wait for with patience. The word of the Lord.
Amen.
The response to the psalm is, what marvels the Lord worked for us.
What marvels the Lord worked for us.
When the Lord delivered Zion from bondage, it seemed like a dream. Then our mouth filled with laughter, on our lips there were songs. What marvels the Lord has worked for us. The heathens themselves said, what marvels the Lord worked for them. What marvels the Lord worked for us. Indeed, we were glad. What marvels the Lord worked for us. Deliver us, O Lord, from our bondage, as streams in dry land. Those who are sowing in tears will sing when they weep. What marvels the Lord worked for us. They go out full of tears, carrying seed for the sowing. They come back full of song, carrying their sheaves. What marvels the Lord worked for us. Let us stand to greet the gospel.
Alleluia.
To you everything I have learnt from my Father.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory.
Jesus said, what is the kingdom of God like? What shall I compare it with? It is like a mustard seed, which a man took and threw into his garden. It grew and became a tree, and the birds of the air sheltered in its branches. Another thing he said, what shall I compare the kingdom of God with? It is like the yeast a woman took and mixed in with 3 measures of flour until it was leavened all through. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please do read and pray through and reread chapter 8 of Romans. It does present us with an amazing sense of the action of the Spirit within our lives, within the lives of the church. And to hear that we are this glory of creation, the wonder that God is working out within us, is a tremendous lift to us, especially in these times when people are coughing and bringing the plague into church.
I wouldn't allow you to...
So let us be encouraged by what we're taught of the role of the Spirit. We'll play a song of the Spirit after or at the time of communion. Chad and said, so I get them right. It said they were the first amongst the English. The English didn't exist for another couple of centuries, but they were Anglo-Saxons. Both educated at Lindisfarne, under Aidan, so this is a pivotal change from the Celts being Christian, and these are the first of the invading Saxons to choose to become Christian, and studying in this great, as it were, a Catholic university, a seminary on the island of Lindisfarne. Chad became abbot of Lastingham, was chosen a bishop of Northumbria, which was a vast area, including great swathes of eastern Scotland. But Wilfrid contested his appointment, and Chad obediently withdrew. He was then sent as bishop to Mercia, from here right the way down through the Midlands, and he founded the See of Lichfield. His ministry there was very short. He died on the 2nd of March 672, but was immediately revered as a saint because of the holiness of his life, his outstanding humility, and his dedication to preaching the gospel. The custom of the monks and the priests of Lindisfarne was to walk everywhere, both on occasion, but to walk, never to ride, because that will give you a position of superiority, and they always wanted to be able to be eye level with those they met on the road. Said founded many monasteries and was sent as bishop to evangelize the East Saxons. He established his see at Bradwell in Essex and died at his monastery in Lastingham in Yorkshire in 664 of the plague. And we really do have to recognize that their ministry was incredibly dangerous. The Celts have been defeated and pushed to the edge of this country. And the Saxons, the Angles, the Jutes, they had absolute control and they very much enjoyed worshipping their pagan gods, Thor, Woden, Freya. It gave them license to do all sorts of things. And to this, they go out, Chad and Sed, without an army, without a horse, and looked these warriors in the eye with nothing but the good news. We live in a time of absolute apathy. I've been doing some clearing up at home, the decorators in, and I found a whole series of First Holy Communion pictures going back years, swathes and swathes of children, not a single one of them, even before COVID, would be in church any time of the year. Our time is such a challenging time to be encouraged by Chad and Sed to share the good news, to look people in the eye and let them know the joy and the glory we have as the first fruits of the Spirit, as creation groans waiting for us to bring about this rebirth. So let's really be encouraged today in our ministry. Pray that Chad and Sed will intercede for parish renewal and our desire to become missionary disciples. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously.
Now we can travel a bit. I can recommend you to go to the Church of St. Chad in Holt on the Welsh side of the Dee, just outside of Chester. Stunningly beautiful church, really. It's worth the journey just for that. And then when you cross back over to England, there's a fantastic ice cream shop. So what's not to like? We pray the Lord will encourage us as pilgrim missionaries. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously.
Pray for our high school, St. Chad. Pray for James, who is now the acting head, and please God, will soon be appointed as the substantial head. I've met him now twice. I've met also one of his newly appointed senior leaders, John Paul. Do you think he's Catholic? He's from the north of Ireland. I think he's Catholic. Both of them really impressive and really desiring to build up bonds again with the communities that first of all built St. Chad's, the Catholic community, but also now the Anglican communities, and want to draw us into the life of the school, but also participate in the life of the parishes. So let's pray for their work, that they will truly be encouraged and be given the wisdom, the first fruits of the Spirit. Lord, hear us.
Lord,
in silence, we offer the Lord our personal prayers. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious,
and the intention of our Mass is for evangelization inspired by these two great saints. Good Father, we ask you to hear the prayers of your children, grant them for us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Before I forget it, when we are next able to go out as a parish on pilgrimage to go to Lastingham, the monastery of said, there is a small chapel that survived, that would be a fantastic thing to do. It looks stunning. Sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and
the
Lord's
salvation. Receive, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, which we bring for the feast day of Saint Chad and Sed. In your kindness, render us fully acceptable by giving us sincerity of heart. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For as on the festival of Chad and Sed you bid your Church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his, of their holy lives. Teach us by their words of preaching and keep us safe in answer to their prayers. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim.
Holy,
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Mark, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. It's just dawned on me as we prepare to pray the Our Father that Chad and Sad would have been first taught this prayer in one of the Celtic language, a Brythonic language, and then translated it into the Saxon. So let's be aware of this incredible connection across the centuries of the passing on of this beautiful prayer for which we need the Holy Spirit. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold, the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
us pray. May the Saviour we have welcomed at this altar, O Lord, gladden us on the feast day of Saints Chad and Sed, on which, with longing for your favour, we honour the precious beginnings of our faith and proclaim your wonders in the saints. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please do check the Mass sheet for the changes tomorrow and Thursday. Mass will be in the evening at Edwards tomorrow with the funeral liturgy in the morning, and then Thursday we're here at 10 o'clock because there's maintenance work in both of our churches. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks everyone, see you now.
Jenna. The head wasn't screwed on.